So chemistry MCQ discussion for IMU common entrance test, which is presented by me, myself, Dr. W. Anbudurai, working as assistant professor in chemistry, PSNZ, Tirunelveli. So this MCQ discussion is only for the applicants who have applied for a marine engineering course entrance test, which is conducted by IMU. So first, nuclear chemistry MCQ questions will be discussed. So nuclear chemistry, it is a wider branch of chemistry that is deals with nuclear reactions and radioactivity, and then nuclear fission, nuclear fusion reactions. So first MCQ questions is to sterilize surgical instruments, which of the following radioisotopes is used? Options are iodine-131 and chromium-51 and iodine-123 and cobalt-60. So sterilization is the major impact, and radioisotope technologies, sterilization is the important role in medical devices since 1960s. There is a substantial knowledge of its effects on both reduction and reduction of microorganisms to prevent disease and changes to material properties, as well as considerable experience in its use. The equipment used in cobalt-60 based on the sterilization is easy to use and maintain, and generally which is reliable. So cobalt-60 is the best answer for this question. To sterilize surgical instruments, which of the following radioisotope is used? The answer is cobalt-60. So second question, the types of radiation with the greatest ability to penetrate matter is option A, alpha, and option B, visible light, option C, gamma, and option D, beta. So the correct answer is gamma. Why? Because the gamma rays can be emitted from the nucleus of an atom during radioactive decay. They are able to travel 10 tens of yards or more than in the air and can easily penetrate the human body. So the best answer is gamma rays. These types of radiation with greatest ability to penetrate the matter is gamma. So question number 3, which one of the following nucleides is most likely to decay by positron emission is? So options are copper 68, copper 63, copper 67 and copper 59. The best isotope is copper 59. Why? Because that neutron proton ratio is low, so it will be stabilized by emitting positrons. So which one of the following nucleides is positron emission is? Copper 59 isotopes can be used. So question number 4, which of the following nuclear reactor components is used to slow down the fast moving neutrons without absorbing them? So option A, control rods, option B, coolant, option C, fissile materials, and option D, moderator. So best option is fissile materials. Why? Because the neutron moderators are a type of material in a nuclear reactor that work to slow down the process, which is produce the splitting of atoms with the fission compounds like neutron uranium-235 to make them more effective in the fission chain reaction. So question number 5, in a radioactive nucleus, it emits one alpha particle and two beta particle. The doctor of nucleus is that which of the parent nucleus? So isobar and isotope and isoelectronic and isotones. So you must know the definition for isobar and isotopes. So isotope definition is a same atomic number and different mass numbers. The number of beta particles emitted by a radioactive atom is twice. So number of alpha particle is emitted by it. So the resulting doctor of atom is isotope of the parent nucleus. So best option is isotope. So in boron neutron capture therapy, the initial boron isotope is used, and then the particle generated after neutron captured respectively are option A, boron 11 and alpha particle, option B, that boron 10 and beta particle, option C, boron 11 and beta particle, option D, boron 10 and alpha particle. So the best option is boron 10 and beta particle. Why? Because boron neutron capture therapy is best of the upon nuclear reaction that occurs when boron 10 is a stable isotope which is irradiated with lower energy and thermal neutrons to yield the alpha particles helium 4 and recoiling lithium 7 nuclei. So question 7, the first step in the disintegration of uranium is uranium 238, which is leading to a 234 thorium. What particle is emitted in this reaction? So alpha. So alpha particle is a helium nucleus. That two helium is two atomic number and four mass number. So which is radiated M, which is emitted by these reactions. It contains two protons and two neutrons. For a mass number is 4. So 238, which is a loss of helium atom, which is a helium is alpha particle, so that alpha particle is emitted in this reaction. So question number 8, which type of radiation does the most tissue damage but only when emitter is internally ingested? Alpha particle or beta particle or neutron or gamma particle? So best option is alpha particle. Alpha particle is the most harmful internal hazard as compared with gamma rays and beta rays. So radioactive material that emit alpha and beta particle are most harmful when swallowed and inhaled by the human beings or injected or absorbed by the medical system. So which type of radiation does the most tissue damage but only when the emitter is internally ingested is alpha particle. So question number 9, which type of radiation has the greatest penetration ability? So option A alpha, option B beta, and option C gamma rays, and option D beta plus positron rays. So explanation: gamma rays for the count. Which type of radiation has the greatest penetration ability? It's gamma rays. Gamma rays and X-rays have higher penetrating power than the beta particles and alpha particles, which travels several tens or tens to hundred of meters in the air, which is depending upon their energy, and gradually lost their energy as they collide with their atoms in the air. So best option for this question is gamma rays. So question number 10, nitrogen 12 is most likely to decay by that gamma emission and beta emission, alpha emission, either positron emission or electron capture. So best option is both positron emission and electron capture. So these are feasible decay modes and for nitrogen 12 because they allow nucleus to achieve more stable configuration by either reducing number of protons or increasing number of neutrons. So specific decay mode for nitrogen 12 is that occur depends on the factors such as the energy difference between the initial and final states, that ground state and excited state, as well as the availability of the electrons in the atom surroundings. So best option, nitrogen 12 is most likely to decay by either positron emission or electron capture. So next is a radiochemistry. Radiochemistry, which is mostly relevant to the nuclear chemistry, which is highly discussed and deals with the radioactivity of the elements. So which scientists discovered the radioactivity? J.J. Thomson and Madame Curie and Henri Becquerel and Rutherford. The best option is Henri Becquerel. He belongs to French and he's a physicist, and he observed that radioactivity in the year of 1896 while conducting experiments with uranium salts. He also discovered that photographic plates become fogged even when not exposed to the light, which is indicating the presence of unknown radiation could be penetrate the matter. So that he has discovered the radioactivity in the year of 1986. So which of the following scientists discovered the radioactivity is Henri Becquerel among J.J. Thomson and Madame Curie and Rutherford, and have same atomic number but different atomic masses. So which of the following is best? So isotope and atom and radioisotope and none of these. So among isotopes are known as same, which has same atomic number and different mass number. So isotope as known as the atoms of same element having same atomic number, but it has different mass numbers. So which is the best option for isotope? An atom is a tiny particle of the element, and radioisotope is an isotope having that radiation energy. So have the same atomic number but different mass number is isotope. When a radioactive substance is subjected to a vacuum, the rate of disintegration per second is increases only if the product or gaseous increases considerably and decreases. Okay, Henry is not affected. So Henry is not affected is the best answer. Why? Because the rate of disintegration is dependent on the number of radioactive atoms present in the element only. So in vacuum, rate of disintegration is not affected. When a radioactive substance is subjected to a vacuum, that rate of disintegration per second is Henry is not affected. So radioactive has an unstable nucleus and undergoes radioactive decay. Radioisotope are none of these. So radioactive has an unstable nucleus which undergoes the radioactive decay is radionuclide or radioisotope, which is a nucleide has excess nuclear energy which is making unstable. So the best option is radioisotope. So which of the following are gamma rays? Gamma rays has lower energy waves or higher energy protons or high energy electron or high energy electromagnetic waves. The best option is high energy electromagnetic waves, because that radioactive elements emit three kind of radiations such as alpha, beta and gamma. Gamma rays are the high energy and electromagnetic waves with shorter wavelength, high frequency. So this is the best option. Which of the following are gamma rays? The high energy electromagnetic waves is the best answer. So which of the following has no charge? Gamma rays or beta rays or alpha rays or cathode rays? So gamma rays, which of the following has no charge, which means alpha has protons and beta has -1 electron, cathode has also has charge. So no charge, which means alpha, gamma rays has no charge, no electrical charge which is associated with them. They belongs to electromagnetic radiations, so which has no charge. So gamma rays has no charge. Which of the following the smallest particle of an element that retains the properties of an element? So isotope or atom or radioisotope are none of these. So an atom is the smallest particle of an element having the same chemical properties, which is atom is a tiny particle of an element. So which of the smallest particle and retains the properties of an element is atom. Hydrogen bomb is based on the phenomenon of nuclear explosion or chemical reaction or nuclear fusion or nuclear fission. Hydrogen bomb is a very well known for a nuclear fusion reaction, which is based on the principle of uncontrollable nuclear fusion reaction. So nuclear fusion is the process when the nuclei of two light atoms combine to form a heavy nucleus, which is a nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion, that smaller nuclei are fused together to form a heavy nucleus. So hydrogen bomb is based upon the phenomenon of nuclear fusion. So which of the following uranium gives the stable isotope of radon, krypton or polonium or radium? The best option is polonium. Why? Because polonium has no stable isotopes, but 210 polonium as one of the product is the decay in the series of a naturally occurring radioactive isotope, that 238 uranium and 20 less than else. So polonium is the best option for the uranium gives stable isotope. So penetrating power of proton is greater than the electron or lesser than the electron or greater than neutron or Rutherford. So lesser than the electron is penetrating power of proton. Beta particle are highest energy of electrons and very light as compared to the atom and tend to scatter and bounce a lot as compared to a proton. protons are about 8000 times heavier than the electrons, so electrons are have high penetrating power. So electrochemistry, it is a branch of chemistry which deals with the flow of electrons and flow of due to the flow of electrons as well as the that photovoltaic cell, electrochemical cell, electrolytic cell, which is discussed in the electrochemistry. So from the MCQ test, MCQ questions, which of the following does not belong to the category of electrochemical cells? Voltaic cell or photovoltaic cell or electrolytic cell or fuel cells? So best option is photovoltaic cell. Why? Because photovoltaic cell is not an electrochemical cell. Photovoltaic cell converts the solar energy into electrical energy with process is called photovoltaic effect, which is photovoltaic effect is phenomenon due to the an electrochemical cell. It is a type of electrochemical cell which is used to convert the electrical energy into chemical energy. So which of the following does not belong to the category of electrochemical cell is photovoltaic cell, because that which is solar energy into electrical energy. So in dry cell, which of the following is a which of the following is the electrolyte? So electrolyte is a solution format. So potassium hydroxide or sulfuric acid and ammonium chloride and manganese dioxide. So best option is ammonium chloride. A standard dry cell comprises of zinc anode, usually in the form of cylindrical part with the carbon cathode in the form of a central rod. That electrolyte is ammonium chloride in the form of paste next to the zinc anode. So in dry cell, that ammonium chloride is act as a electrolyte. So the process of transmitting electric current through an electrolyte solution to decompose, it is known as that process is which is electrolyte or electrode or electrolysis or electrochemical cell. So you can know that electrolysis is the best option. Electrolysis, which is the process of transmitting electric current through an electrolyte solution to decompose the atoms. So electrolysis is a process which the electric current is passed through a substance which is called electrolyte to effect a chemical change. That the chemical change is one in which the substance losses or gains an electron. That process is called oxidation or reduction. Oxidation is a gain of electron is a reduction. Loss of electrons is a product. Process is known as oxidation. The process transmitting electric current through an electrolyte solution to decompose, that process is known as electrolysis. So in a fuel cell, which of the following can be utilized as a fuel? So nitrogen or argon or dihydrogen or helium. So best option is hydrogen, because all other is belongs to the gas molecule. In fuel cell, chemical energy which is converted to electrical energy. So hydrogen and oxygen gases are used in a fuel cell along with water and heat. So in fuel cell, which of the following can be utilized as a fuel? Can be hydrogen. So which of the following is given to a fuel cell's cathode? Hydrogen or nitrogen or gas, oxygen or chlorine gas. So best option is oxygen gas. An anode and cathode and electrolyte membrane to make a fuel cell. In normal fuel cell, hydrogen is passed through an anode and oxygen is passed through via cathode. So oxygen is the best option for the fuel cell's cathode. I select the strong electrolytes. So as hydrochloric acid or acetic acid, propionic acid and H2SO3. So HCl, hydrochloric acid, is the best option for strong electrolytes. The strong electrolytes, why? Because that it can be act as best electrolyte. Acetic acid and propionic acid and sulfuric acid are weak acid in the electrolytes. So strong electrolytes, which means the hydrochloric acid can be used as a strong electrolytes in the electrochemical cell as well as electrolytic cell. So select the weak base and weak base electrolyte. So sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide or calcium hydroxide or alkyl amines. So best option is alkyl amine. Why? Because sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide and calcium hydroxide are the strong base and strong electrolytes when compared to the alkyl amines. So alkyl amines are the weak base and it can be used as a weak base electrolytes. and dilution ionization that has in electrolyte. So which increase or which and dilution that ionization which increase or decrease or becomes very small or do not, there is no change happen in the electrolyte. So best option is which increase, and dilution ionization which increase. If any of its solutions can be Na plus and OH minus ions are very separated. So in electrolyte ionization increase while upon dilution till the whole of the electrolyte substance has ionized. So special type of cell known as DAS in which of the electrolyte is placed. So conductivity cell or conductance cell or equivalent cell or conductance cell. So conductance cell is the best option. So the electrolyte is placed in a special type of cell known as a conductance cells. The conductance is made of highly resistant class such as pyrex or quartz. So which of the following does not belong to the category of electrochemical cell? Electrochemical cell which is electrical energy which is converted to chemical energy. So which of the following not belong to the category of electrochemical cell is either acid or metal or alloys or oxides. So best option is acid by themselves do not belong to the category of electrochemical cell because they do not generate electrical energy through the redox, which means reduction and oxidation reaction. Reduction reaction which is gain of electron, oxidation reaction which means loss of electron. So electrochemical cells involve the conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy through the redox reaction. So acid will not generate the electron. So the best option for the following does not belong to the category of electrochemical cell is acids. So thermodynamics, a well stoppered thermo flask contains some ice cubes. This is an example of which system? So closed system or open system or isolated system or none of the thermodynamic system. So there are three types of system are there. So which is a open system, closed system and isolated system, where the open system that energy can, both energy can be transferred, closed system no energy can be transferred, isolated system neither exchange of matter nor the exchange of energy is possible with the surrounding. So thermo flask will not allow the exchange of matter and the energy with the surrounding. Hence the example of isolated system that no energy can be shared with the surrounding. So a well stoppered thermo flask contains some ice cube. This is an example of isolated system. For this reaction, carbon plus O2 which is produced carbon dioxide which is delta H is less than delta U, that internal energy and enthalpy change. How the changes between enthalpy and internal energy. For the above reaction that formula enthalpy can be converted. Enthalpy is equal to internal energy by delta nRT. PV is equal to nRT, that in enthalpy is equal to internal energy. For this reaction that gas energy is equivalent, so delta H is equal to the internal energy. For an ideal gas, Cv minus Cp are related as Cv minus Cp is equal to R, Cv plus Cp is equal to R, either Cp minus Cv is equal to R or Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So this is the best option, D is a correct option. For an ideal gas, Cp minus Cv is equal to R. R is a gas constant, so it is the difference between the heat capacity at constant pressure and heat capacity at constant volume for is the ideal gas. So this is a relationship, best relationship. So the least random state of water system is ice or liquid water or steam or randomness is same. So ice, so least randomness is randomness which means that order or disorderness. So disorderness is very low in ice cube. So that very low is the ice cube. So least random state is H2O, be the solid state, that is ice. So randomness is very low, so ice is the best, least random state of the water system is ice. The correct relationship between free energy change in reaction and the corresponding equilibrium constant Kc. So that formula is well known, the Gibbs energy, delta G is equal to RT ln Nk. So whereas the constant minus G or Gibbs free energy minus Gibbs free energy or delta G is equal to RT ln Kc. So the best option is minus delta Gibbs free energy is equal to RT ln Kc. The relationship between free energy change in a reaction and corresponding to the equilibrium constant Kc is delta G naught, delta G naught, which means free Gibbs energy, which is equal to minus RT ln Kc or minus delta G is equal to RT ln Kc. So what is the entropy change? So entropy change unit is joule per Kelvin and mole per mole. When 1 mole of ice is converted into water at 0 degree Celsius, the enthalpy change for conversion of ice to liquid water is 6.0 kilojoule per mole at 0 degree Celsius. So this is a problem that where ds equal to dq reversible by t, where ds equal to 6.0, so 6000 joule per mole, the kilo which means 1000, so 6 into 1000, 6000 mole per. So whereas temperature is 273 Kelvin, if you apply to 21.98 joule per Kelvin per mole, you will get the answer. So what is the entropy change when 1 mole of ice is converted into water? 0 degree is 273 Kelvin, so you have to apply the values ds equal to dq reversible by t. So ds equal to 6000, so divided by 273 Kelvin, so you will get the 21.97, which is 21.98 is the best answer. So when water is added to quick lime reaction, so which is an explosive reaction or endothermic reaction or exothermic reaction or photochemical reaction. Explosive is action reaction, endothermic which is a heat enter inside reaction, exothermic is a heat liberated during a reaction, photochemical reaction a chemical reaction which is initiated by a photo or light energy. So best option is exothermic reaction. When water is added to a quick lemon, that reaction is exothermic. So that equation in the form of calcium oxide plus water, which is leading to the formation of calcium hydroxide. So delta H is negative, so exothermic, so heat is liberated when water is added to the quick lime. That reaction is exothermic. So which of the following is an application of thermodynamics? So refrigerator or gas compressor or power plants are all of the above mentioned. So which of the following is an application of thermodynamics? So power plant are the application of thermodynamics. Why? Because they utilize the principle of law of thermodynamics to convert the heat energy into mechanical work and ultimately they are into the electrical energy which is the power plant are widely used. So that applications of thermodynamics can be applied to power plants compared with the other refrigerator and gas compressor and other options. So power plant is the best option for the applications of thermodynamics. So which of the following is the type of thermodynamic system? So there are several types of system. There are open system, closed system, isolated system. Isolated system can be classified into thermally isotope and all of the above mentioned. So which of the following is a type of thermodynamic system? Is three types of system are there: thermodynamic system, or open system, or closed system, and isolated system. Open system, in this type of system, matter and energy both are exchanged between the surroundings and the system. That closed system, there is no interchange between the matter in a closed system. Isolated system, which means an isolated system has no exchange of energy or matter with its surrounding. So which of the following is a type of thermodynamic system, which means all of the above mentioned is answer. So what is the value of absolute thermodynamic temperature scale? So 3 Kelvin or 0 Kelvin or 1 Kelvin or 4 Kelvin. So 0 Kelvin is the well known answer. So the value of absolute thermodynamic temperature scale is 0 Kelvin. So carbohydrates are the very broad range of chemistry, which can be that sugar test and all other items, the sucrose and maltose, that can be studied by the in the carbohydrates. You might have studied in your 12th standard. So from that, my MCQ question can be asked in the IMU entrance test. A positive Penetics test is not given by the lactose, maltose, and sucrose and glucose, which is a Penetics reagent, is the sugar test reagents. So Penetics reagent, which is used to test the commonly used to check the presence of reducing sugars. However, the other reducing sugar, reducing substance also given the positive reaction, which is includes the monosaccharides and many disaccharides, including lactose and maltose. Sucrose contains two sugars, fructose and glucose, joined by their glucoside bond in such a way that it is prevent to glucose isomerizing to aldehyde, so that fructose to alpha hydroxy ketone form. So whereas sucrose is thus non-reducing sugar, which does not react with the Penetic reagent, so which will not give the positive Penetic test reagent. So sucrose is indirectly produce a positive result with the Penetic reagent if heated with hydrochloric acid or prior to the test, although that after this treatment it is not no longer will be sucrose. So a positive Penetic test which will not be given by sucrose. So the most important epimer of glucose is you must know the epimer definition. So arabinose or fructose or galactose or xylose. So galactose is the most important epimer of glucose of the human neonate. So the most important epimer of glucose is arabinose or fructose or galactose or xylose. So galactose is the best answer. So an analog of starch is cellulose or glycogen or sucrose or sucrose. So there is a typo error in this question. So analog of option is glycogen. Glycogen is the storage of form of glucose in animals as well as humans. So which is the analogs to the starch in plants. Glycogen is the storage form of glucose in animals and humans, which is analogs to the starch in plants. Glucose is a monosaccharide and is hexose and pentose and furanose and sucrose. So explanation is for this question is glucose is a monosaccharide and which is a hexose. Glucose is classified into monosaccharide because it cannot be broken down further upon the hydrolysis process. So it is further classified as a hexose because it has a 6 carbon skeleton and as a aldose because it presents for aldehyde group and carbon number 1. So glucose is a monosaccharide and it is a hexose because it has 6 carbon skeleton. So linkage between two monosaccharides, which is an ionic bond or covalent bond or hydrogen bond or glycosidic bond. Because the monosaccharide is a glycoside, so glycosidic bond is the best option. There is a linkage between saccharides. Two monosaccharide units can be joined together by glycosidic bond. This is the fundamental linkage among that monosaccharide building blocks found in the oligosaccharides. Oligosaccharide, which means poly, that glycosidic bond formed between two anomeric carbon of the one monosaccharide and hydroxy group of another. So linkage between two monosaccharide is glycosidic bond. So if carbonyl group is an aldehyde, monosaccharide is So if carbonyl group is an aldehyde, monosaccharide is ketose or dextrose or aldose or maltose. So whereas aldehyde is in the presence of carbonyl group, which means aldose. So if the carbonyl group is an which has aldehyde group, which means monosaccharide is an aldose. If the carbonyl group is has ketone, which means that will be answer is ketose, that monosaccharide is ketose. Monosaccharide with three carbon atoms, that has called as a triose. These are the smallest monosaccharides, such as dihydroxyacetone and D and L-glyceraldehyde. So if carbonyl group is an aldehyde, that monosaccharide is aldose. So three carbon monosaccharide are called as trioses or tetroses or pentoses and hexoses. You might collect the answer from the absent itself. Tri, which means three, so trioses is the absent. So three carbon monosaccharide are called as trioses. Monosaccharides with three carbon atoms are called as trioses. And these are the smallest monosaccharide, such as dihydroxyacetone, D and L-glyceraldehyde. So starch is a glucose polymer in which glycopyranose units are bonded by alpha linkage and beta linkage and gamma linkage and none of the above. So starch is glucose, that polymer in which glycopyranose units are bonded by alpha linkages. Why the starch is a glucose polymer in which glycopyranose units are bonded by alpha linkages? It is only made up of that mixture of amylose, which is approximately 15 to 20%, or amylopectin, or 18 to 85%. So that minimum number of carbon is in monosaccharide is, that minimum number of carbon should be in the monosaccharide is number 1 or number 2 or number 3 or number 4. The minimum number of carbon should be 3 numbers, because that monosaccharide is a single polyhydroxyaldehyde, which is aldose, that single ketone, which is a ketose. Glucose is a single polyhydroxyaldehyde, while fructose is a single polyhydroxyketone, that which has that monosaccharide under its skeleton are of a carbon atoms. The minimum number of carbon atoms should be 3, or it can go up to 7. So minimum number should be 3 in the monosaccharide carbons. So example of epimers. So already we have discussed that epimer in the previous questions. So example of epimers. So glucose or galactose, or glucose or ribose, or ammonia or glucose, that both A and C. So that you can find the answer from glucose and galactose. Why? Because that both glucose and galactose have the same chemical formula, but the orientation of hydroxyl group at the carbon number 4 is different. So that glucose and galactose is best example for epimers. Why? Because that glucose and galactose have the same chemical formula, but the orientation of hydroxyl group in the position is different. So epimer, best epimer is glucose and galactose when compared to the other absence. So chemical kinetics, that some of the main problems will be asked from this unit. So that can be first order reaction, or that order of the reaction can be asked. So first question is, for first order reaction A, which is produced to B, that rate constant is x per minute, that initial concentration of A, that product is 0.01 molar, the concentration of A after 1 hour is given by the expression. So each of the following is absent. So A, 0.1 e power x, which means x that time, a constant which at what time. So that you have to apply the formula K is equal to kinetics, K is equal to 2.303 by per time, and into log to the power product by reactants. So you can give a round of plus that per minute, so 1 by T into ln to a product by reactant. So x into that concentration, you can have the concentration 0.01 molar. So you can have that per time in the 60 minutes. So a into 1 into the y, 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 into e to the power minus 60x. So is the best answer. That is the correct answer for the question. A zero order reaction, x the product which will give the product with an initial concentration that at concentration molar is 0.02 molar has half life of 10 minutes. If one start with concentration 0.04 molar, then the half life is 10 seconds or 5 minutes or 20 minutes or cannot be predicted using the given information. A zero order reaction can be produced through the initial concentration. That initial concentration we can have the 0.02 molar. So option C is the best answer, 20 minutes. So you can apply the same formula that n minus 1 k into the A reaction. So T of the half life period A by 2k. So T of is directly proportional to the product reaction. So A is the half life in the so 0.02 molar and T of 10 minutes. In a 10 minutes they can have the starts then with concentration 0.04 molar. 10 minutes is directly proportional to the 0.02 molar. So T of is 0.04 molar. The equation 3 can be divided by equation 2. So T of 0.4 divided by 0.2. So 20 minutes can, 2 into 10 minutes, 20 minutes can be the best option. Question number that for a reaction rate, the kinetics that most of the problem can be asked. So you have to memorize the formula and the chemical order of the reactions. So for a reaction rate, the K is the reaction constant, acetone of 3/2 and acetone, then unit of rate constant, rate of reaction respectively is. So option is a mole per liter and per second, and that best option is mole per that a mole of that reaction rate can be unit of rate is equal to mole per or mole per liter divided by second. Unit of rate constant is a mole per liter and per second, which will be divided by mole per liter in n number. So which can be n number can be applied. So mole per mole 1 minus n and liter n minus 1 and s per second. So in this case rate constant can be acetone of 3/2, so n equal to 3/2, so n can be 3/2, so n mole per n minus n, l my 1 minus 3/2 and the 3/2 minus n, 3/2 minus 1 and s. You have to apply in this unit of rate constant mole L minus N, where you have to apply that N equal to 3/2, you will get the answer of that best option is B. That addition of catalyst during a chemical reaction which alter the which of the following quantities. So catalyst which is speed up the chemical reaction, which will not affect the reaction but which will speed up the reaction which is go faster and rapid manner. So catalyst do role is to speed up a chemical reaction without involving in a chemical reaction. So addition of a catalyst during a chemical reaction alter which of the following quantities. So enthalpy will not be affected by catalyst, entropy will not be affected by catalyst, and internal energy will not be affected by the catalyst. So because the activation energy can be affected by the catalyst, because that energy can be that to speed up a chemical reaction catalyst is added. So addition of a catalyst during a chemical reaction which alter the activation energy. A catalyst provide a new path to the chemical reaction with a low activation energy. Because it lowers the activation energy, catalyst itself that speed the chemical reaction to go faster. So in a reversible reaction, that enthalpy change and the activation energy in the forward direction are respectively kilojoule per mole. So problematic topic can be discussed in the brief manner in the next lecture. Therefore, the energy of activation in the backward direction. So this is a in a reversible reaction, which means that near reversible reaction, which means that a curve reactant and reactant product can be that it is a upward and a downward arrow can be that obtained. It is a zigzag arrow that can be x plus y. So x plus y, that best option is x plus y into 10 to the power of minus 3. So that is the best option. That rate constant of a chemical reaction is 5.8 into 10 to the power minus 2 per second. That what is the rate order of the reaction is, that whether first order or zero order or second order or third order. That the unit of a rate constant is per second, which means that which refers or which represent the first order reaction. That unit of rate constant is per second, and which will indicate the reaction rate, that first order. So during the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, which will to give the dioxygen, and 48 gram of oxygen is formed per minute at certain point of time. That rate of formation of water at this point is that you have to apply the formula H2O2 hydrogen peroxide, which will split into H2O and oxygen, 1 by 2 oxygen. So rate constant can be d by dt, d into that reactant and H2O2 and product. Number of moles of oxygen is 48 by 32, so you can have 1.5 mole. Rate of formation of oxygen 2 into 1.5, so 2 into 1.5, 3, so 3 mole per minute, which means that during the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, which will do dioxin 48 gram, 48 divided by 32, 1.5, so 1.5 into, which means 2, that decomposing water at this point is 2 into 1.5, so 3 mole per minute. So question number 58, the half-life period of radioactive element is 140 days after 560 days. Half-life period of a radioactive element is 140 days after 560 days. 1 gram of element will be reduced at what time? In 140 days, that initial concentration can be reduced to half gram. In 280 days, initial concentration can be reduced to 154 gram. In 420 days, that initial concentration can be reduced to 1 by 8 gram. So in 560 days, that initial concentration can be reduced to 1 by 16. So half-life period of a radioactive element is 140 days after 560 days. 1 gram of element will be reduced to 2 in 560 days, or that initial concentration can be reduced to 1 by 16. So we are almost coming to the closure of this session. After 2 hours of radioactive substance become 1 by 16th of original amount, then the half-life. That half-life which has to be given in minute, so that is 60 minutes. After 2 hours, that radioactive substance become 1 by 16th of that original amount, which will involved in the reaction, involved in the radioactive process. Whether 60 minutes or 120 minutes or 30 minutes or 15 minutes. So 30 minutes is the best option. So you have to apply the T half and T half half and half half converter into 1 by 4 and you have to apply T half that 1 by 8. That will be 1 by 16. So pour into T half 2 hours. So 2 hours can be 30 minutes. So what is the activation energy for a reaction? If its rates double when the temperature is raised from the 200 Kelvin to 400 Kelvin. So R is called the gas constant. Gas constant, you are well known about the gas constant, 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. So you have to apply for the formula T1 equal to 200 Kelvin, the K equal to K1 concentration for an from 2 reaction. So T2 is a 400 Kelvin, K equal to K2, so 2K1. So log K2 by K1, where you have to apply the 2.303 divided by RT, which means T1, T2 minus T1 and T1 into T2, where you have to apply log 2K2 divided by K1, where you have to apply 2.303 EA, which means activation energy, divided by R gas constant. Gas constant, you are very well known about gas constant, 8.314 into joule per Kelvin per mole. And you have to apply the temperature 1. Temperature 1, which means temperature 2, 400 Kelvin. Temperature 2, 200 Kelvin. So you have to multiply for the T1 and T2. So you will get the activation energy 434.65 joule per mole. So thank you very much. All the best for the entrance test. So I wishing you all the best to score and get the basic Bachelor of Engineering in Marine Department. So all the very best once again. So thank you very much.